Welcome to the air-to-ground missile tutorial. Air-to-ground missiles, or ATMs, are useful for precisely hitting light to medium armored ground targets. First, power up the targeting pod. Welcome to the air-to-ground missile tutorial. Air-to-ground missiles, or ATMs, are useful for precisely hitting light to medium armored ground targets. First, power up the targeting pod. You will use the TGP to designate targets for the AGMs. Now arm the weapon system. And switch to the AGM-114. These are small, laser-guided anti-tank missiles. Since they home in on the laser point emitted by your TGP, you must maintain line of sight to the target until it hits. To fire it, designate a target using the TGP, point your aircraft at the target until the missile locks on, then pull the trigger to fire. You can also switch the missile seeker's uncage mode to manual, which will allow you to fire at targets off foresight. In manual mode, you hold the trigger to uncage the seeker, then press the weapon switch button to fire. Try shooting the targets around the mission waypoint using the AGM-114. Remember, you need to maintain line of sight with your TGP in order to guide the missile to the target. Welcome to the air-to-ground missile tutorial. Air-to-ground missiles, or AGMs, are useful for precisely hitting light to medium armored ground targets. First, power up the targeting pod. You will use the TGP to designate targets for the AGMs. Now arm the weapon system. And switch to the AGM-114. These are small, laser-guided anti-tank missiles. Since they home in on the laser point emitted by your TGP, you must maintain line of sight to the target until it hits. To fire it, designate a target using the TGP, point your aircraft at the target until the missile locks on, then pull the trigger to fire. You can also switch the missile seeker's uncaged mode to manual, which will allow you to fire at targets off foresight. In manual mode, you hold the trigger to uncage the seeker, then press the weapon switch button to fire. Try shooting the targets around the mission waypoint using the AGM-114. Remember, you need to maintain line of sight with your TGP in order to guide the missile to the target.
Altitude. Autopilot disengaged. Autopilot disengaged. Autopilot disengaged.
Welcome to the radar tutorial for the FA-26. Today you will learn how to use the radar to find and track other aircraft, as well as designate targets for air-to-air missiles. First, open the Radar MFD page. The radar must be manually powered on using the radar. The display shows you a compressed representation of the radar's 120-degree field of view. The display range can be adjusted using the R+ and R- buttons. Press the R+ button repeatedly. As the radar sweeps over other aircraft, they will be displayed as blue icons for friends and orange icons for foes. The left-to-right scan angle can also be adjusted to allow the radar to scan more rapidly but in a smaller slice of the sky. The number shows the angle in degrees off boresight. Set the radar as a sensor of interest. Now you can slew the target designator using your joystick's thumb control. Slew the designator over a contact and press in on the center of the thumb control to start tracking it.
Autopilot disengaged.
You can track up to 4 contacts while still being able to scan the rest of the sky.
Autopilot disengaged.
They will appear as a small circle on your HUD, along with the corresponding number. In order to lock a target for weapons, you can either click the track again using the designator, or press the numbered MFD button on the left. While the target is locked, the other tracks will continue to be displayed, but the radar will not be able to scan for new targets. Information about the locked target's bearing, range, altitude, airspeed, and aircraft type will appear in the bottom right of the display. Use the unlock button to unlock the target and the clear button to clear the tracks. For close-in engagements, the radar can be switched to boresight mode using the mode button. In this mode, the radar will point straight forward and lock under the first contact it sees. If the radar is SOI, you can press the joystick thumb control to quickly unlock and find a new target. Now for some weapons practice. Go back to scan mode and find, track, and lock the enemy aircraft.
Over T.
Over T. Over T. Over T. Over T.